teach you how to paint a flower basket. And I already have my rolled out fondant, my palette plate with my colors, and then my painting brushes. So as usual, we are going to start with a pencil tip brush with our brown color. You start by making a curve, a rising curve. Rising curve, like a slope. It's falling, it's falling, 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 and rising. So you have it like an S shape, kind of rising, falling, and then rising. This same. After that, from this end, from this end, okay, then you have your base here. Time to do some cleaning. We've done the base. We do have a second base. Okay. Our hand is going to start from here. Stop here. The second one. Okay. It's time to shade with our brown and yellow. Yellow. We are still using brown and yellow. To fill the background. Okay. Now it's time to add details. You have to highlight the initial sketch. Alright, now that we have highlighted the initial sketch, we are going to put the patterns on the basket. Basically four lines, not perfect straight lines. Now if you remember what we did on the first fruit basket, we did like a semi U shape, a kind of a U shape. This time we're going to do an arc kind of pattern. That means we start from up, down, instead of in, out, instead of like a U shape. So we're going to do this. Just straight strokes. Some small center. We do the same thing we did on the other basket here. Okay. Just finish it off. Alright, our basket is ready. The next thing we want to do is... to fill our basket with flowers. I'm going to start with pink. Make a circle, then a petal shape. Another one here. Part of it is in the basket. Part of it is behind the pink. So, it's going to come out here. Part of it is coming out here. Now we're going to start filling our flowers. We start shading from the tip, from the initial stroke, inside, inward. Don't shade everything, leave some touch of white. That will add life to your work. You can see the effect of the white. Do the same thing with the red. We're going to fill the other space with just tiny effects. Okay. We fill the middle with contrasting colors. It's time to draw our lips. If you want a light shade of blue, just add yellow. Fill up the spaces with green. Okay, that's all. So we're going to do the same thing we did with the other basket here too. Cut around it and transfer it to our main cake. So I'm just cutting around it. It's very easy to cut when you have a sharp craft knife. So I can still cut from each side. All you're doing, you're just cutting around the details. Alright. To transfer, all you need is apply some spirits on your cake. Sorry, our brush is stained, but no problem, since we are going to cover our spots. Gently lift your work, gently. It's a bit firm now because it's dry a little. Position it on the cake. See that? See that? It's beautiful. So I want to push it to the side a little. So that I can have space to write a message beside it. I want to write, "Happy birthday, Mom."